Hello everyone, and let's welcome and congratulate Dr. Gokul Das. He's ranked 22 May PGI 2017 postgraduate exams, and he also secured a rank 7 in NIMHANS neurology group. Right, heartiest congratulations, Gokul.
Thanks.
How do you feel, Gokul?
I feel really happy, very happy, much relieved right now.
Much relieved, right?
Yeah. And totally grateful to sincere gratitude towards DAMS faculty.
That's very sweet of you.
Actually, I joined in January.
Okay.
I couldn't do well in my last exam, so pretty disheartened after that.
Right.
So I joined test and discussion DAMS from January onwards.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was a pretty most appropriate decision I took.
Okay.
And the DAMS faculties are incomparable to, and the
That is so sweet. We are humbled. Thank you so much.
And the notes also, the exactly precise notes, they don't, we don't have to study anything apart from them, just they're precise and you can revise it in the, maybe in the last months also.
Yeah. Okay.
Very much handy.
Wonderful. So, Gokul, can you tell us that since you were with us in the TND course and he's managed in a short span of time, he's converted himself into one of the top ranks. Gokul, how was your strategy in the TND, during the TND course?
Actually, DAMS provides us the schedule of the TND, so
right.
we would have 1 or 2 weeks before the particular exam.
Yes.
So, I used to focus on that subject.
Okay.
Maybe 1 week before.
Okay.
And after the TND also we can 2-3 days we can give for that subject.
Add on the updates and newer stuff.
Exactly.
Okay.
Actually I followed the DAMS schedule only, that's all.
Okay. So he just followed the schedule pattern and gave the tests accordingly. Huh. Right.
Regularly we have to give grand tests.
Right.
We could know where we stand.
So he's given all the grand tests as well, and were the questions in the subject test as well as grand test of good quality, and do they match up to your real exams?
Exactly. Well, they won't repeat the exact questions. Still, the topics are pretty much related to the same.
Yes. Okay. So it was beneficial to
give
focus on those topics and do them more intensely.
Yes.
Great. And did you attend the visual session, Gokul, that we kept?
Yeah. It was pretty much handy. Actually, for PJ, they won't ask any.
Yes, but visuals.
For NEET and AMC, it would be very much beneficial.
Okay. Great. And did you give the mock test as well, Gokul?
Yeah, I did.
And how was it?
It was a good experience. We could almost like an AIMS pattern.
Yes. Great. And Gokul, since there are 19 subjects and the stress levels are high and the time is less, how do you suggest your juniors should divide time for these 19 subjects, and what should they stick to so that they can revise things towards the later part?
Actually, I focus mainly on the minor subjects.
Okay.
And you have to give him 40-45 days for revision.
Okay. I think you should all listen to him very carefully, right?
And I think, according to me, I guess 3-4 revisions are
mandatory. Right.
Unless you won't remember.
And what do you want the students to focus on during their revision time?
I would say mainly focused on minor subjects.
And is it more of notes or more of questions?
I focus on more on notes.
More on notes.
So that you could be strong in your topic.
That's
right. More important.
Because they don't repeat questions,
they don't repeat,
right? So you have to know the topic more intensely so that you can answer any other MCQ also that comes on that topic. That's nice. So he's kept 40-45 days for revision. That's what he says. And he's focused mainly on the notes. And do you think that there is a lot of need to study here and there from all those guidebooks that are available? And
I don't think we just have to know the topic.
Right.
According to the current pattern, they won't repeat much.
Yes.
So no point in reading from the guides too much. You can't rely too much on
and
the guides.
And you can't revise them as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So I would say stick on to the notes.
Okay.
Revise as much as you can.
Okay.
So.
Right. And do you think regularly giving tests and grand tests and mock tests should be a part of your curriculum?
Yeah, exactly. Definitely, giving tests, you could be touching with all the subjects.
Yes, so it's a form of revision, right? A passive revision.
or else you will forget focus some topics.
Yes. So he's saying you are doing actively a few subjects, but once you give the test, especially the grand and mock, you are in touch with the other subjects as well, and that's like a form of revision itself.
Exactly.
Okay, that's great. Okay, Gokul, and any special advice that you want to give to your juniors?
I would say, madam, persistence is main.
So I think this time all toppers, I've interacted with so many of you, and one word that comes out of every topper's mouth is persistence. So you know, people feel that toppers are just lucky people. Tell them that it's so much of persistence that goes. I mean, this word is unanimous among toppers, that you know, it is the persistence which has worked for them and has converted them into toppers, right, Gokul?
Exactly.
That's wonderful. So any last message that you want to give?
Any
faculty that you want, that you like at DAMS?
Radio.
Just to make the thing more interesting.
Dr. Sumesh sir.
OBJ. Okay, thank you. Because I'm sitting there, they will say my name. Okay, thank you so much. I'm humbled.
Physio, surgery, notes were very much.
Okay, physio and surgery notes. Very good. Great. So, just some last motivational message for people who are there and who are probably thinking, no, AIMS is not my cup of tea. Something that you want to say to them.
I'd say,
PGI is not my cup of tea.
Well, stick on to the your passion. Well, never give up.
Never give up.
Yeah,
so he says, stick to your passion, never give up. So this is Gokul, ranked 22 May PGI postgraduate entrance exams. Heartiest congratulations once again, Gokul.
Thank you.
And I wish you a very bright future ahead. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thank you.